looking at famous songs and albums that were removed from stores and why. First off, we have Taylor Swift, and it's her whole catalog that was taken down. So it's gonna be forever. This was not on music stores? Wait, is this a Spotify thing? I know she was against Spotify for a while. Oh yeah, she just re-released this as well, right? A new recording. I think because people she doesn't like bought the rights to the original. Taylor Swift has a lot of bangers. All the music videos are crazy too. I've heard this song enough. Oh yeah, this is the new stuff. The fairy dust, that's funny. In 2014, Taylor Swift removed her whole catalog from Spotify. This was after giving critique to streaming services. "I think there should be an inherent value placed on art," she told Time. After pressure from her fans in 2017, she re-uploaded her songs. I was under the impression that they would pay artists better, but maybe they didn't. I know Spotify is still kind of like pushing the value of music down a little bit. Here we got Lady Gaga and Katy Perry. Banned in China? What? My mama told me when I was young, all of their music. Is it because they don't wear appropriate attire for China? I like this song now. I don't think I liked it that much when it came out, actually, but listening back to it now, it's pretty sick. There's a stranger in bed. It's a weird video. Rebecca Black's in this as well, right? Me, when people party close to me, I'm just watching anime and I'm like, can't they stop partying? I can't hear what Sudoku you think. Sudoku. Big brain. In 2011, the Chinese government started to ban songs in the country. Among those were Lady Gaga's Born This Way and Katy Perry's Last Friday Night. They were banned for poor taste and vulgar content. What? Because they're about like partying, and I guess Lady Gaga's is about sexual identity as well. Nowadays, you're gonna have to do a lot of censoring to censor those things. By the way, welcome back to another daily video. My name is Joel from Rooney Official, and here's a meme from the subreddit. This is how it works. Singer is off key. So Joel says it's a little bit pitchy. You know the rules and so do I. Exactly, that's it. Why do we look so similar here? Boyish men in glasses. Very nice. I want to be manly. I just don't have the capacity, okay? I'll never be an alpha. Various K-pop songs removed from Spotify. What? Oh, this is a lot of big artists here. Hey. I've seen this before. I love this. Why are the productions always so sick in K-pop? Sistar, that's not how you spell sister. Which they obviously were trying to do. That's a funny dance. I could maybe do that dance. I tried to dance in this video if you haven't seen it. And I am not amazing. I can say that right now. But this dance, maybe I could do. I wouldn't look as good as them though, because my legs don't look like that. My legs look like little sprouts, little bean sprouts. ULGO BULGO. I love that. ULGO BULGO. I want to sing that all the time now. Whenever there's a K-pop word I don't know, I'll sing ULGO BULGO. Because I know that's real Korean words now. Earlier this year, Spotify removed hundreds of K-pop songs after a license dispute with the South Korean distributor Kakao M. Releases by popular acts, including Sistar, IU, Monsta X, and Epic High vanished, leaving fans frustrated. 2 weeks later, they resolved the dispute and the songs are back again on the platform. Well done. Well done. Here we have Adele and her album 25. Hello. Why was this taken down? How are you? It's so typical of me to talk about myself. I'm sorry. So hell from the other side. I must have called 1,000 times. It's a sick song. I read in a review of this that someone thought that they had melodyned her voice a little bit too much. Like, it's very straight and very much like exactly on the note. But I think it sounds good. I'm pretty much always pro vocal tuning, even in stuff like this. In 2015, Adele was the best-selling artist in the modern music business. She defended that crown by keeping her latest music off of streaming services, including Spotify and Apple Music. "I don't use streaming," she told Time after the album's release. The album sold a whopping 8 million copies in the US alone. However, the year after, she made the album available for streaming. So it was definitely a business move. I don't see why else you would do that. She wanted to sell more physical albums, and she definitely has the audience to do that. Oh, and also, if she doesn't release the singles as CD singles, then the only way to get the music is to buy the whole album. That's kind of genius and also very, very business-minded. Big brain. And here you got Gnarls Barkley with their song Crazy. Oh, that's like a Clockwork Orange reference, surely. I remember when I lost my... This was so huge. There was something so pleasant about that place. I think they took this down because it was overplayed, right? Does that make me crazy? Cool voice. In 2006, the act behind the number one selling single of the year pulled the track from music stores. In a statement released by Gnarls Barkley and their label Warner Music, the pair said that they removed it from stores so that listeners would remember the song fondly and not get sick of it. That's such a cool thing to do. I love that. It was getting really overplayed. And I think I talked about this before. People tend to get irritated with a lot of falsetto singing if they hear it too much. There's just something about it. If someone's like... I mean, you're probably already annoyed, let's be real. But if that was good sounding, then still, you'd probably get annoyed with it eventually. Next up, we have Lady Gaga's Do What You Want featuring R. Kelly. Ooh, R. Kelly, he's a little bit controversial. I can see that might be why. I love that type of like synthwave bass. Do what you want with my body. Yeah, I remember this. Do what you want with my body. She kind of sounds like Christina Aguilera on this. Do what you want, with my body. Do what you want with my body. What you want with my body. Like the growl there as well. I miss this era of this type of production. Sick. In the wake of Lifetime's documentary series Surviving R. Kelly, a growing number of celebrities, musicians, and former collaborators have publicly denounced R. Kelly, including Lady Gaga, who removed her R. Kelly feature Do What You Want from all platforms. That does make sense. I don't remember exactly what it was, and I'm not gonna look it up because I don't want to be sad today. So let's just move on. Next up, we have Milli Vanilli and their album Girl, You Know It's True. They're the people who didn't sing their own songs, right? So this is lip syncing then. Why would you choose these guys to be the faces of it? Is it just that they're cool looking? Ah! The shoulder pads! Yes! It doesn't even sound like the singers on the actual recording are very good. That was terrible. Sorry, that is just not good anyway. In 1990, Arista Records removed Milli Vanilli's album Girl, You Know It's True from stores very quickly after Frank Farian admitted that Rob Pilatus and Fab Morvan did not sing on the record. Rednecks were the same. Like Cotton Eye Joe, they didn't sing on that. Next up, we have Jay-Z, and they took down almost his entire catalog. I wonder why. Hit me. 99 pounds for the game one. This beat is so dope. Tell by my attitude that I most definitely leave from. This is iconic. Is he still releasing stuff, Jay-Z? I feel like I haven't heard of him in forever. Jay-Z. It seems he still releases stuff, but mainly collaborative stuff. Like, Everything Is Love with Beyoncé as the Carters, released in 2018. So yeah, he's still at it. Once rapper and business mogul Jay-Z bought the streaming service Tidal in 2015, it was only a matter of time before he started using his own impressive catalog to entice subscribers. He made all of his major work Tidal exclusive. In 2019, he returned to other streaming sites. How did Tidal even go? Is that still a thing? I guess it is. It is the first place I think of if I think about high quality streaming, but that's not really anything I seek out. I think MP3 just sounds fine to me. Even on really nice speakers. XXXTentacion and R. Kelly Spotify ban. That's interesting. I love this song. Such a vibe. Never seen that music video. Everything she took my heart. He's fighting himself. Broken heart contentious. I won't fix, I'd rather weep. Ouch. That looked like it hurt. Don't do that, guys. Just to think that This is such a good song, and he's so problematic. Yes. It is a good song. It's like mainly a funny song and like a true vibe. I think I've sung this thousands of times, just the first two lines. Such a meme. I believe I can fly. Amazing. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I love it. These two artists weren't banned from any stores, but in 2018, Spotify removed them from both all official playlists and recommendation features on the service. This happened after the Me Too movement, when both of them were accused of abuse. Here we got Beyoncé and her album Lemonade. Why was that not on stores, you may ask? Well, we're about to find out, so shut the frick up. Trying to roll me up. I ain't picking up. People love this album. It doesn't like speak to me super much, but I can get it. That was cool. I like that. When Beyoncé released her album Lemonade, she decided to not release it anywhere except for the streaming service title. Maybe it was to support her husband, Jay-Z, who is the owner of the company. Maybe. Who knows? Maybe she just wanted high quality streaming. A few years later, the album was finally made available on all other services. Because you gotta earn money at some point. You gotta have some subscribers. I'm sure Tidal is fine. I'm sure there's some Tidal people watching my content. Let me know in the comments if you're on Tidal. Here we got Manic Street Preachers and their song, The Masses Against the Classes. That's dope. The groove kind of reminds me of Queens of the Stone Age a little bit. The drumming as well. Dave Grohl is such a great drummer. I don't know who this is, but it all sounds like really aggressive and nice and everything's so tight with the guitars. I love it. Sick. I wonder if proper screaming is gonna come back to mainstream music at any point. I think it might. I don't know, maybe not to mainstream. Remember when pop punk had a bunch of screaming and pop punk was a big thing? I don't feel like there's an equivalent right now. Maybe Corpse can bring it back. Hey Corpse, bring it back, okay? Manic Street Preachers 2000 single, The Masses Against the Classes, was deleted on day of release as a promotional gimmick. However, copies of the single continue to be available until supplies ran out, which allowed it to reach number one and remain in the charts for 7 weeks. That's really funny. There's a lot of that here, like the Adele business move and this business move. I guess it works. You got Prince and all of his music. Is that still not up? Maybe it isn't. This one has almost the same qualities as I Believe I Can Fly, right? It's also how good is this? Prince was such a cool artist. In 2015, Prince banned his songs on Spotify, Apple Music, SoundCloud, YouTube, and Deezer. Some are easier to control than others, but even YouTube was heavily patrolled. Yeah, and now with Content ID, it's probably impossible to find. The reason is still unclear, and after Prince's death, all of his music was made available again. Okay, I assume it was money? Seems like most people who don't want their music streamed do it to earn more money and feel like it's devaluing the music, which is fair enough. They can set their own prices, decide where the music is gonna be made available. I just think if you're not on streaming services now, you're gonna become irrelevant very quickly. Here we got Def Leppard and their whole catalog was taken down. This sounds so much like We Will Rock You. Sick. Oh, this is an amazing chorus. Not very high, it just sounds very good. How high is that? I guess you could say that an A flat is high, but it's not too bad. Pour some sugar on me. Pour some sugar on me. Wow! Def Leppard's whole catalog wasn't available in any online stores for many, many years, except for a few live recordings. In 2018, they came to their senses, so now you can stream all of their songs. Yeah, I think everyone wanted to try to sell records because records just brought in more money, but people listen online now. That's how it works. The annoying thing is that companies like Spotify take too big of a cut, I would say. And also record labels have found a way to take a lot of the revenue as well. I think artists earn less percentage-wise than they ever have. I think so. Don't quote me on that. Okay, guys, can you get more music commentary videos? Can you get more music videos? And I will see you tomorrow in another daily video. Here's another meme from the subreddit. Oh, this is sick fan art. I love that. Are you a hamster? This looks hamster size. Send a selfie with it if you are an art hamster. I'm uploading the new Lil Pitchy song today. It might be up when this video comes out. I don't know. It just depends how long it takes. Go follow Lil Pitchy on Spotify to get a notification. See you tomorrow. Bye.